Hi everybody, I just want to show you my observation of current propagation of Tesla system. Here I have my schematic. As usual, I have here my Slayer exciter as transmitter. And here I have another coil as receiver, and on the receiver side I have here a load. It's a light bulb, 5 watt, 12 volt light bulb, and at the bottom of the receiver coil is connected to the earth ground, and the Slayer exciter circuit is powered by a power supply which has also an earth ground connection. And from my observation is we have here at the bottom of the receiver coil the current, and around the top of the receiver coil or a Tesla coil we have a voltage. Okay, so I have here another schematic. So I think it's the equivalent circuit would be like this. This is two coils. These are two coils. One as a transmitter and the other one as a receiver with ground connection. It would be like this. Two coils with ground connection, you will get the most current around the bottom of the coils and the most voltage at the top of the coils. So here I have another equivalent coil. It's like a bipolar coil where you have earth ground connection in the middle of the coil, and at both ends of the coil you have just open connection, so you will get the most current around the middle of the coil and the most voltage on both ends of the coil. So I will show you my actual setup. This is my actual setup. Here I have my Slayer exciter as transmitter, powered by a power supply, and here's my receiver coil with ground connection. And here is my 5 watt 12 volt light bulb. And here I have my tuning capacitor. It's just a insulated plate. It's an aluminum foil, not connected to anything. And here I have my, this is another 5 watt light bulb, just as a reference, will be powered by this 12 volt battery. Okay. I'm going to turn on the power supply. Let me turn off the light. Okay. Now I'm going to position the tuning plate to get the maximum brightness of the light bulb. Okay, now I'm going to turn on the reference light bulb. There are they have same brightness. Here is the voltage, and here is the current drawn by the Slayer exciter. And now I will. Oh, okay. I have here this nylon so that I can lift up the coil up to here. Now I will, okay, the nylon is and hanging at the on the ceiling. Now I can, by pulling this rope, I can lift up the receiver coil. Okay. I will do it again from the bottom. I will lift up the receiver coil. I don't know if you can see the intensity of the light bulb. Okay, now the light is glowing dimly. let's see, at its maximum brightness. I will do it again without the reference light bulb. I will lift up the receiver coil slowly. Okay. You see that the light bulb has the maximum intensity at the bottom of the coil with this configuration. It means that you have maximum magnetic field because of the maximum current at the bottom of the coil. And then I will show you with this that at the bottom you have no voltage. Okay, going up, on this position you still have electric field, until this high, go down, you have this electric field, the high voltage field, go down, it's off. So from my observation is you have at the bottom of the coils maximum magnetic field because of the maximum current, and on top of the coils you will have maximum voltage and minimum current. And I have shown you that the field, the electric field, goes further up above the top of the coil. Okay. correct me if I'm wrong. And again, here is my setup. Until next video, bye-bye.